Today, the topic is actually the organic basis of children with special educational needs. How many know children with the special needs? We heard about several health needs. And while I am not an academic expert actually, basically I am a clinician and researcher. So all you people are from the academic side, especially the teachers and the remedial trainers. So you might be, while I am going through several papers of these children with special health needs, I could see many of the projects in India are concerned with special topics of some health problems related to this education, especially the visual impairment, orthopedically handicapped, the visual impairment. And these are the usual areas where mainly the academicians are concentrating up. I don't know what is the reason for that. Once I asked it to some educational experts at that time, they told that there are several funds for orthopedically handicapped children, visual impairment children, and hearing impairment children, and MR and others. These are the five headings that I could see in several papers. But our medical view is entirely different. Even though this visual impairment is a medical issue, what I am going to deal with here, the organic basis is not related to this vision, not only related to this hearing, or it may not be confined to mental retardation, because mental retardation is a broad heading so far a doctor is concerned. That's fine. So let's see one paper. Organic basis, it means, what does it mean? Education at organic basis means the learning program has a background of organ. Which is that organ? Basically, brain, all we know. Only that? Do you feel like that? No, obviously no, because you are dealing with hearing problems, you are dealing with visual problems and everything is there. All you know, right now, at present moment, our cognition will be very well produced. Because we had good paisam, it's so sweet. So sweet means we will be so sleepy, no doubt. If we are feeling sleepy, it means that we are normal. If you don't feel sleepy, we are a little bit abnormal. This is the physiology. You see, here, the organic basis, let's see. Before that, let me introduce my institution, Vaidyanatham PS Vaid Rayanatham College is going to celebrate its 100th years of its establishment the next year. The great visionary Dr. P.S. Vaid was the founder of this college. And my credentials are given in this website, www.ethicalayurveda.com. If at all you come across with any sort of doubt after this class, you can just leave a message through this website. There will be a call for the message in contact. You can just leave a message. Definitely, I will reply for that. The topic under of my presentation will be like this. Let's know the gravity of problem in its true sense. How much this problem is prevalent nowadays in India. And identify the case not only in terms of diversity criteria. Diversity criteria is very, what we can say, this is a big pitfall. Otherwise, this is a big barrier in front of us. Because diagnosis of learning disability, there will be a special administrative tool, isn't it? Have you seen that? Learning disability diagnosis programs? Anybody of you? Please lift the hand. Now,
You have not gone through that. Have you heard about the DSM, Diagnostic and Statistical Manual? Have you heard about it? Okay. In that, there is a diagnostic criteria for learning problems, for reading, for arithmetic problems, all those other, but from medical point of view, it is a big barrier. When we come across with several other students in schools, so identify the case not only in terms of diagnostic criteria, not only in terms of diagnostic criteria of learning disability or dyslexia, know the organic base for children with special educational needs. I will teach you some physiology of brain, I will teach you some physiology of learning, and I will show you how the brain works for a bit of it. And non-medical interventions instead of medicine, in addition to medicine. Otherwise, we, even without medicine, how can we deal with those children? These are the areas where I need to concentrate. This is a statistics regarding the prevalence of these children with special educational needs. This is produced from the NCERT website. I feel the back, the fellows who are sitting on the back side, they cannot see the actual figures, it seems. Right? You can see. There are five headings in it, mainly. There will be visual impairment. The data distributed according to the rural wise, urban wise, and total governmental, non-governmental institutions. Hearing impairment, orthopedic and handicaps, mental retardation and others. Mental retardation and others. If we just add the mental retardation and others, what will be the weight, you know? This will be more than the visual impairment, more than the orthopedically handicapped, and more than the orthopedically handicapped. How we will assess a case as mental retardation? Maybe we will see the child initially, and after that we will have an interview. And after that, we will take the IQ. The clinical psychologist usually take the IQ. No. And if the IQ is less than a prescribed level, we will call it as mentally retarded. The very same thing in UP, upper primary school also. More number is towards the MR side and others. Others is a large group. Maximum number of children in India who needs special attention in their educational area are MR and others, not visually handicapped, not hearing impaired, or not orthopedically handicapped, my view. So, where we need to start and where we need to put the exact pin. This is a big issue. Actually, whether there is a need of a doctor to take a class in such an occasion, it's a big question. Whether a doctor is needed to treat the case of autism, whether there is a need of a doctor is needed for a case of learning disability, is a big question nowadays. Others is a big group, and especially this is the real area where a doctor's presence is needed, or a doctor's help is needed. This others group. And MR is also a group where doctor is intermittent. You know this figure very well. Isn't it? Pachakudra, delimited. Left. What is the diagnosis of this condition? This is Asperger's syndrome. Of course, in film, there will be exaggeration, not ours. There will be exaggeration. It's an exaggerated figure of Asperger's syndrome. Asperger's syndrome is a type of autism. So, get put on the real name. Here, I share it. IDS Asperger. He is Asperger.
May I Zahu interview you. Then my name is Khan. All these are Asperger syndrome. Asperger syndrome is an autism. It's a high functioning autism, which is having a clear cut organic basis. And this fellow is in need of treatment, no doubt. Not only treatment, but he is in need of treatment. Because he has some physiological problem, he has some organic problem. And this type of good number of children are there in our school itself. And if you have a teacher, how many of you are teachers in school? Only one? Rest of the people are in college, it seems, no? Okay. Very minimal number of teachers are there from school. Okay. And high functioning autism is very well prevalent nowadays, and according to our government statutes or government standards, all they are coming under either EMMA or others. Because if you are taking IQ of these children, sometimes they may be MR or sometimes they may be high intellect. If they are high intellect but still they are high, very well behind in the academy, then all assessments are going to a final conclusion, that is they are coming under others. They are coming under others. By looking itself, we will come to know that this baby is having some problem, isn't it? There are problems on eyes. This is not a Strausser syndrome. What I meant to say from this picture is that if we put this category under EMMA, that is an injustice to this kid. Because of course this baby, this child is mentally retarded, not else. Mentally retarded means, it means that those cases who are in MR diagnosis, they need only the psychological support. But this baby doesn't need, not only need this psychological support, this baby is in need of several other medical interventions. So this type of people are there, good number of people are there in our government schools. But all they are considered under mentally retarded. Okay? How many times we know the certain film or certain other films in which this seasonal disorder will be shot as the jerky movements of the hands and legs, right? But can you see, suppose I will say one example. One child, he is in second standard, he always smacks his lips like this. Always he is chewing something. Whenever we are opening the mouth, there will be nothing. There will be chewing, simply chewing. Yes. This is a type of epilepsy. Idhu apasmaram. But most of the teachers are unable to understand this condition as epilepsy. So what do we mean? Every time the child will be scolded by the teacher, that claiming that the child is sitting in the class with chewing something, and sometimes there will be some pieces of sweets in their mouth. Have you heard about the rumination disorder? Rumination, you know the word meaning of rumination. Rumination means ayavarattuka. In Malayalam it is known as ayavarattuka. Probably the child may have the halwa at 8 a.m. and after that the child will chew something at 11 a.m. when we open the mouth, it can be seen that there will be disintegrated parts of this halwa. The baby himself, the child himself has taken out this halwa from the stomach and he started to chew it. This is a type of epilepsy. He won't study. He will get usually C+ or C. Even though he may be intelligent. Whenever you are going for any IQ assessment, the baby's IQ will be proper. He will not be mentally retarded. At that time we will claim that out, the teacher may not be out, the system may be inappropriate. All these will be the claims usually seen. All these are, how much percentage of these children are there in our schools? That is the big question actually. A good number of others. What I shown here in the statistics, others are coming under this group. Seizure disorders are coming from the brain due to abnormal production of electricity from the neurons. Abnormal production of electricity from the neurons. Can I get a chalk piece, please? Dr. Sadhana was. He told me to arrange one chalk piece. Okay, click. If I am getting a chalk piece, it will be very easy to communicate with you how these are producing these intelligent problems. Okay. And this is one child. This is foreign child. But see the peculiarities. What are they? They are oriental. This ear is large in child. Did you ever mean it? Did you ever mean it? Dibyoti is changed in the case of white and famous. The dibyoti is normal. What I am telling is, this is a manufactured defect. In usually, we are teaching the students, our students, as if it is a manufactured defect. Because everything, this indicates some problems in the brain. If the baby is having problem, otherwise no. Because everybody, those who are having this type of auricular problem, and not like that. I will not say like that. Yeah. This is fragile X syndrome. Elongated face. Long face will be there. Ever cut auricle will be there. And this baby will be usually diagnosed as mentally retarded, MR. But the case is not MR. This is fragile X syndrome. By treatment, we can improve it. Not only with the psychological approach. You might have seen some children in your class, especially in the UP classes, wherever they are approaching to the puberty. Tall fellows, abnormally tall. Ajanu Babu. Ajanu Babu, malla rakshana vayittana malayaligal, alage sanskrutathile, sahityathile, okke parayunnathu Ajanu. Ajanu, Janu means knee joint. Ajanu Babu. Babu means hand. Hand up to knee joint. How ugly it will be, you see? If my hands are up to this level, how ugly it will be. But it was an icon of handsomeness or beauty at that time, during our ancient days. But you see, this is an abnormality. And there are tall fellows, elongated face, and there will be hands up to this knee joint. And if we are seeing their fingers, the fingers will be of different morphology, different size and shape. They are known as Marfan syndrome. Marfan syndrome people are sometimes very intelligent. Marfan syndrome sometimes they are MR. I know several Marfan syndrome. I have several patients Marfan syndrome. They are high top engineers. But they should go for regular checkup. That's the only issue. But what I meant to say is that Marfan features are cases which are plenty in our school, and we usually claim it as MR. And there are several other children who are thrown out from the mainstream due to the academic structural issues or system issues. All we know, Ardhoma. Isn't it? He was brilliant. His IQ is so super. Probably it may not be covered on this language IQ. And I don't know how this is happening. You may be much more expert in this, because whenever we are applying an academic curriculum or system in 100 students, there may be some students that they will be thrown out from the mainstream, isn't it? We usually have we usually put this example as the glove. If you are wearing it, if it is proper, it will be so nice. But the glove are, if the glove are not suitable to that hand, it will be very bad to operate, and it will be very bad to
when we utilize our hands. So proper glove is needed for each and every student. This is the best academic system, and usually in our ancient system, especially in Ayurveda, 2000 years back, this was the system. And every student will have an attachment to the teacher, and there will be a suitability of the academic curriculum in a lock and key mechanism between the teacher and the academic curriculum and the student. Nowadays, we usually claim our academic system like this. You might have seen this world famous cartoon. Have you seen it? Anybody of you? It was viral in WhatsApp, isn't it? There's an elephant, penguin, monkey, and a fish, dog. The class is how to climb the tree. Teacher is instructing how to climb the tree. What will happen? And teacher is expecting, moreover, teacher is expecting equal performance from all these members. How it will be? And this is the problem of education system in India. As per my understanding, I don't know how much I am correct because I am not an educational expert, but we usually quote this cartoon in front of the teachers. Please try to manage yourself and your academic curriculum and your administration of class, especially in front of the teaching, in front of the students, while delivering the lectures. Try to mind this cartoon, especially as well as the backbenchers. There will be fish, or there will be elephants. They may be very tall, or they will be big in size, but there may be elephants. How to climb the tree? Diagnosis. The main point, what I need to say is that the exact diagnosis is very well needed, at least from the part of the teachers, just to understand whether the case is, that the case has to be referred to a doctor or not. Whether the case, a medical attendance is needed or not. അതിനൊന്നും പറ്റും, ടീച്ചേഴ്സിനും പറ്റും. ജസ്റ്റ് കുറച്ച് കാര്യങ്ങൾ, ഫോർ എക്സാമ്പിൾ, ബിഫോർ ഗോയിങ് ടു ദ റെമഡിയൽ തെറാപ്പീസ്, ബിഫോർ ഗോയിങ് ടു ദ സ്പെഷ്യൽ എഡ്യൂക്കേഷൻ പ്രോഗ്രാംസ്, യു ജസ്റ്റ് ഹാവ് അനദർ ക്വസ്റ്റ്യൻ ഓർ ക്വസ്റ്റ്യൻ റിഗാർഡിംഗ് ദ ഫോളോയിങ് ഏരിയസ് ദാറ്റ് ഐ വിൽ സേ യു, ദാറ്റ് വിൽ ലീഡ് യു ഓർ ദാറ്റ് വിൽ മേക്ക് യു അണ്ടർസ്റ്റാൻഡ് ഹൗ ടു അണ്ടർസ്റ്റാൻഡ് ദ പീപ്പിൾ ഹു ആർ ഹാവിംഗ് ഹു നീഡ്സ് ദ മെഡിക്കൽ അറ്റൻഷൻ. If somebody is complaining, teacher, why are you in Malappuram area? You know, in our area, so many neighborhood of our college, there are several schools, government schools. All the teachers are complaining about the whole. These students are very low in academic performance, C, C plus. These are the ranks. Doctor, what do we do? It's not an issue of doctor. Let us evaluate the case initially, and we will diagnose if you are going there, if you are going to the class, and if you are taking the class, and after that, if you are analyzing the case one by one, people understand that there is a certain percentage of students who need the medical attention, who are having very low rank in the class, very low performance in the class, and we call them as poor scholastic children with organic background. So they are having organic basis. So we are not going for the assessment of learning disability. Learning disability is what the assessment tool is not going to do. DSM criteria is not going to do. Clinical psychologist is not going to do. We are just administering a set of questions, and we are just evaluating with the help of teachers. We are evaluating the case one by one, and we are segregating the children as they are in need of medical attention, they are not in need of medical attention, like this one. So these people are having educationally, they are educational, they are special children, and they are in need of medical attention, or otherwise we call it as the children with organic basis for their educational. Okay? Can you say the name of this disease? This disease? There will be flat nose? always smiling, protruded tongue. We usually call it as mandabuddhi. Down syndrome. And what will be the diagnosis from the psychologist? Profound MR. That will be the diagnosis. You see, this is the typical example where MR turns to a medical condition. This is Down syndrome, Mongolian child, Mongolism, what we call Mongolism. And especially this case is in need of medical attention for their academic improvement. So don't be sticky in diagnostic criteria. We put them as scholastic backwardness with organic basis or without organic basis. How to diagnose? We should start from the very beginning. Pregnancy. We should ask to the parents, how was the pregnancy beginning? Was it eventful or not? ഇപ്പോ ഡെലിവറി അല്ലെങ്കിൽ പ്രസവം അല്ലെങ്കിൽ പ്രഗ്നൻസി എന്ന് പറയുന്ന ഒരു അസുഖമായിട്ട് മാറിയിട്ടുണ്ട്. Now it is a disease, turned to a disease. Because without medicine, we can't imagine a delivery. Without the hospital, we can't imagine. Yes, it is good. Delivery should be in the hospital. But it is not a disease. Due to our lifestyle change, what is happening? This turns to a disease. That is why Kunjuni Maharshi told that Pandata Pur, Ipurata Kur. Pandata Pur, Ipurata Kur. That was the saying from Kunjuni Maharshi. See, there are four questions minimal. There should be four questions to the children with the special educational needs, to the parents. There should be four questions. Number one, how was the pregnancy built in general? Was it issue based or not? Issue in the sense, not the issue of rationally, not the issue of husbands. Not only the issue of husbands, it seems. See, all you might have, or otherwise, how many of you are biology students, please? Biology teachers? Biology teachers? Very minimal number. You know, the brain, initially, when we were in womb, how it was? It was, the total body was like this. This was started like this. Then, later on, it will fire into a stick-like structure, like this. And finally, after 2 weeks or 3 weeks, you can see that at the end of this stick, there will be a bubbling. There will be a bubbling. And this bubble will turn to brain. All these are automatic. All we are high believers of God by studying the embryology. Automatically we will want it. And initially you see, here, in the brain, in this bubble, in the center there will be, yes, sorry, there will be some round-like structures, and these round structures gradually it will move to the periphery of this bubble, and this movement is known as migration, and these bubble structures later turn to the neuron. The basic structure or the cell of the brain. Who will design the journey of this migration of these bubbles from the center to periphery? You know? Or what are the factors which are influencing? And this is basically the foundation of intelligence of an individual. How much it has moved out, how much the neurons have migrated to the periphery, is the basis of intelligence, is the basis of cognition. Amma vishamichal, migration korayum. Amma ke thalli kittiya, migration korayum. Amma anavishyamayi endosal phalagathedutthu kazhichal. Or we know, because our vegetables are like that. just like we are eating in the sapphire. Right?
And you can see sometimes, especially in our area, it is very, very common that I am abroad in Gulf, okay, I am working hard, okay, my wife is pregnant, okay. So, I need to send something now. The she is pregnant. In the pregnancy time, there will be much more love from the husband side. And are you going to the hospital? Okay, you are going every day, you are taking the food now? Yes, I am taking, no problem at all. Okay, and I will send you some powder which is so proteinaceous. And it is so common among the Arabians. So I will send the powder. And finally, what will happen? This mother will take a lot of powder, and this mother will take a lot of health pills, and this mother will take a lot of nuts. Mother will like a big ball. And after what will happen? She will deliver a small baby 2.5 kg. Normal weight of the baby is 2.5 to 3.5. And she delivered a baby with 2.5 kg or 2.4 kg. Love her way. What happens? All those go to her body, not to the body of fetus. Here what happens? There is a blockage of whatever we have put into the gut. What we have put into the stomach has not reached the baby. Right? Obviously, the medicine given by the gynecologist is like folic acid, which is very well needed for the growth of the brain, for this migration, will not reach to the brain of the fetus for its development. What will happen? So pregnancy is not a disease. Pregnancy is not a disease, and the pregnancy should be taken care of very thoroughly. The test question is that how was the pregnancy? How was the fluid? In the later trimester, 7th month, in 8th month, obviously, you might have heard about that. The fluid is low or fluid is high. This is very dangerous. And how was the movement? Fetal movement. Or you know, can you not have a thought of the other? What are the There will be a fetal movement. It means that the fetus can hear the sound. Not. Okay? And this movement should be adequate. This movement is a reaction to a particular stimulus. It means that his brain is developing properly, his each and every organ is developing very properly because of the stimulus, different stimulus. Of course, if you are making hearing, or if you are hearing a lot of Kalyani Ragam, not all. It will enhance the brain development. Studies show. Kalyani Ragam, It will add the migration procedure. And was there any antenatal, means the pregnancy time, during the pregnancy time, was there any bleeding or not? These four questions are very well necessary. If these are positive, or any of these things are positive, along with a scholastic backwardness, we can doubt that this baby is having some medical reason for this scholastic backwardness. How to diagnose? Next, nature of delivery. The World Health Organization says that if it is a human being, caesarean section will not exceed 23%. If the organism is a human being, caesarean section should not exceed 23%. In India, it is 31. In Kerala, it is 42. Are we animals? Are we something other than the human beings? See, during this time, whether the baby has cried or not, during the time of delivery, whether the baby has cried or not, immediately, or you know, otherwise, I will just say, one simple example, you might have seen the cake, Gulab Jam. Gulab Jam is the, it is put into a sugar syrup. Fetus lung is like Gulab Jam. There will be lung piece which is not inflated by the air, and it will be surrounded by some fluid, right? And whenever female has the parturition time, lung pain starts,
The journey starts.
Who decides first to get them? Who decides? Whether the mother or baby decides the delivery? Who start to wish to have a delivery? Baby, obviously, due to unknown reason, activates the fetal hypothalamic pituitary axis. Yes, I have to go up. And this baby has to go through a narrow passage of vagina and genital tract, just like a Bharatanatyam. He will make such movements, and after that the baby will be delivered. After 6 hours of time, you see, during this narrow passage, there will be squeezing by the bearing down, the forceful effect of the uterine musculature, there will be squeezing on the chest so that all these fluid of the gulab jam lung will be thrown out of this mouth normally, so that this lung piece gulab jam will be spongy after squeezing out of this fluid, so that the baby can easily take the air. What will happen to cesarean? Cesarean, cutting the abdomen, cutting the uterus, taking out of the baby. Baby immediately stunted. What happened? This was not the program inside me. This was not the program started by my God. What happened? Immediately, for 5 years, baby got stuck. And there is a deficiency of cry. If it is beyond 2 minutes or 3 minutes, it will affect the brain. Especially the main site of intelligence, they are known as periventricular region. Definitely, there are studies which shows the lack of IQ in certain area in children who born after LSCS, lower segment caesarean section. No doubt. So, immediate cry was there. And this milestone has to be specially noted that, like what we call it,
Five months.
It should start from the 3 months. At least by 5th month, he should get second capacity. Otherwise, he should go to a doctor. What development means? This is called as development. Now, what is development? What development means? Have you seen the structure of neuron? In during our 10th standard, we have studied the structure of neuron, isn't it? Initially, during our olden days, after 2 years or up to 1 year of our age, this neuron was naked. There was no dress for this neuron. As the age advances, there will be a dress which is known as myelin. There will be a dress. This is a protein. And as the baby advances his age in terms of month, this myelin start deposit on the neuron so that the baby get the development like networking and standing and walking and speech, and everything is attained by mainly two procedures, out of which one procedure is myelination, which is known as myelination. What I meant to say is that if neck holding is delayed, it means that myelination is delayed. Okay? And if the turning of the time is delayed, it means that in the brain there is delayed myelination. If the crawling, sitting, crawling is very important, you should ask the parents that during the 8th month of time, whether the baby has crawled, one month. If the baby has not, this is a comorbidity, you can see good number of LD, learning disability cases, if you are asking, there will be two specific symptoms. Number one, there will be hyperactivity in LD. Number two, there will be deficient crawling. മിക്കവാറും അമ്മമാർ പറയും അവൻ അധികം മുത്തൂക്കി അഴിച്ചില്ല, അധികം മുത്തൂക്കി ഇരുന്നു, ഇരുന്നതിന് ശേഷം നിന്നു, നിന്നതിന് ശേഷം നടന്നു. And this step will be that, it means that what happened here, this dressing has not occurred or this myelination has not occurred in his brain. Yeah. And sitting, crawling and speech will be delayed in most of the children who are having this learning disability. Epilepsy,
structural deformity, as I told you, regarding the ear, shape of the skull and testicles, genital organs. There are some children in fragile X syndrome, what I told. In fragile X syndrome, there will be large testicles. Until large testicles. On examination, you can see that it is not very cozy. But it will be a large testis, elongated face, and ever apparently not up, it is going to the diagnosis of fragile X. And these are the different deformities which can be seen. See the shape of head. This is the normal head. This is normal head shape. From the superior aspect, what I am telling you. Superior aspect. I am looking from up. This is an abnormality, shapeless. All these shapeless children are not necessarily MR or LD. But if one LD child or if one MR child is having this shapeless head, definitely there is an organic basis. There is a need of doctor. The brain structure and the neuronal structure, we need to just to revise our 10th standard class regarding the structure of the neuron, and there is an axon, and there will be myelin sheath surrounding that, and in organic basis, if we get a group of children who are having special, who are having the educational problems, and we can diagnose the case as either there is an organic basis or there is no organic basis. In organic basis cases, whether the medicine will improve his IQ or not, this is a big question. All we know, kalathu nammude TV thorannu kazhinju njan raathri TV adakkunnathu vare ethum koodal kelkunna oru vaakku ayurvedam ile. Even ayurveda faculty, ayurveda doctors are going to the inner market looking surroundings and after that purchasing the liver oil to reduce their fat. It's so common. So I am the doctor who is able to hypnotize you. If you are putting the name of Ayurveda, everything can be solved. I can sell a chappal, which is Ayurveda. If we are wearing it, we won't die. I am damn sure it will be a hot cake. I know it is like that nowadays. What I want to say is that whether the Brahmi or some of the Brahmi, Matre Brahmi, Marcha Brahmi, what is all the brain rotting? Whether all these will help to acquire our efforts? If I am getting A, if I am taking the Brahmi, the next examination whether I will get efforts? So is it useless to take this Brahmi? Brahmi is needed only when a problem which is curable by Brahmi is there. Whenever a problem which is curable by Brahmi is there, then only the Brahmi is needed. Otherwise, Brahmi is not needed. Useless. Rather, it will be harmful sometimes. If the digestive problems are there, Brahmi is harmful. So what I need to say, there is medical intervention, there are non-medical intervention for this problem from the doctor's point of view, what I am telling. So I got a group of children who are having learning problems and who are having organic basis. The next step is up to the doctors only. The doctors will decide whether this child is in need of medicine or whether the child is not in need of medicine. Okay? There are several non-medical interventions which can provide this improvement in the academic skills. As one session was there in the morning, that yoga sir, he told several techniques. Like that, several non-medical interventions are there. Aim that I can make you understand that what are the areas or what are the problems where I am concentrating or where the doctors are concentrating upon. That is very, very easy to understand. There are several studies in which shows that in children who are having this scholastic backwardness, on functional MRI evaluation can be seen that in some areas of the brain there are some deficiency of blood supply. There are some deficiency of blood supply. And there are some children who are having lack of myelination. I told you what is my ear. And there are some children who are having deficient wiring. What is wiring? 1 + 1 = 2. All we know till our death, till we have algebra or till we have the comma. 1 + 1 = 2. Why? Because it has created a permanent circuit in our brain. That means, if we study one thing, it means that it has recorded as a circuit in the brain. It has recorded as a circuit. Different neurons will join together hand by hand. And after that, they will form a circuit and they will form a permanent circuit and they will say that I am ready to retry and record at any time whenever you ask. How can we produce this wiring? If we study one sentence or one definition today, definitely it will produce a temporary wiring. Initially it will produce a temporary wiring, not by means of these neurons, but by means of several chemicals. Okay, there will be temporary wiring. Everything goes thorough, formative, you might have studied, it seems, during your B.A. classes, Ibn Ghos Karmo forgetting. In that, the famous educational expert, he told that 1, 3, 7, 14, 21, these are the days to be. We need to remember and repeat the sentences to make into a permanent memory. What does it mean? Initially, if we study one sentence, it will create a short-term memory by not means of a structure, by means of a function. And after that, if we repeat the sentence, it will create a circuit. If once a circuit is formed, it means that our permanent memory has created. We will not forget at all. Is it possible by medicine? Simply no. There is no medicine to create a permanent circuit in any of the brain, not only in the human brain, in the mouse, in the guinea pig, anyone. Clear? And there will be deficient wiring in case of children with scholastic backgrounds. There will be some scar tissue. They are going for the MRI. MRI, have you heard about the MRI? Magnetic resonance imaging. That's a special scan. By scanning, we could see that there are several children, that's not the least percentage. In such children, there are some scar tissue. One injury has occurred to the brain previously somewhere during their childhood time or during the intrauterine time or at the time of delivery. Some injury has occurred that has turned to a scar, that is not a sclerosis. And there are some dead tissues. There are some abnormal electric discharges in the brain and lack of migration, as I told you. Lack of migration. The round structures need to migrate to the periphery of the brain. Clear? Non-medical interventions, what we are doing. Areas of non-medical intervention. In all these pathologies, or in all these problems, the area by which this non-medical intervention can help for a child. Number one is deficient circulation. If deficient circulation is not addressed, that will be not by the doctor only, not by you. If deficient circulation is not addressed, no doubt, rather than going for the medicines, better he can go for some non-medical interventions. That I will demonstrate what we are doing. Lack of myelination. You know, in my LD clinic, I have categorized the children into two, ladies and gentlemen, into two. One group of children who have got or who have developed the chronic during their childhood. Second group who have not crawled. What I will do, that's a big heart. Usually Joseph sir is also doing the same thing. I'll leave Joseph sir. And from one corner of the heart, അവരെ അവിടെ നിന്ന് മുട്ടുകുത്തി അടയിപ്പിക്കുക വരെ ഇവിടെ നിന്നിട്ട് ആറ്റം വരെ ഇങ്ങനെ മുട്ടുകുത്തി അവരെ അടയിപ്പിക്കുന്നു. ഇഫ് വി ആർ ക്രോളിംഗ് നോട്ട് ഔട്ട് ദ കറസ്പോണ്ടിംഗ് ഏരിയ ഓഫ് ദ ബ്രെയിൻ വിൽ നോട്ട് സ്റ്റേ സ്റ്റാഗ്നന്റ്. ഇറ്റ് വിൽ നോട്ട് മൈൻഡ് wiring action is an area where non-medical interventions are very effective. Then deficient wiring, as I told you, for the plasticity or for making good connections between the neurons, non-medical interventions are helpful. Deficient circulation, കരയുന്ന കുട്ടിക്ക് പാല് നമ്മൾ കേട്ടു. If I need to increase the blood circulation to my fingertips, what I need to do, you know? I need to work here. If I am working like this, no doubt, the arterial supply, the arteries will expand, the blood will come more in this side. If I am not working, നിങ്ങൾ ഈ യാത്ര ചെയ്യുമ്പോൾ ഒരുപാട് നീണ്ട യാത്ര ചെയ്ത് കാലത്ത് ഊട്ടിട്ടിറങ്ങിയ കാലുമേ നീര് വരുന്നിട്ടില്ല. എന്താ കാരണം എന്നറിയോ? അവിടെ അത് കെട്ട് പിന്നെ അങ്ങോട്ട് പോകുന്നില്ല ഇങ്ങോട്ട് പോകുന്നില്ല അധികമായിട്ട്. അതൊരു ട്രാഫിക് ബ്ലോക്കാണ്. അതിനേട് എഡിമ. And what we need to do for that? During the long journey, we need to flush and extend the legs like this, so that the traffic block will be removed. So, we need to create a demand in the brain. We need to create a demand in the brain, so that at that area, there will be increase in circulation. Clear? How can we demand? How can we make the demand that we will see? Each and every step of the growth and development, like the crawling, sitting, and everything is a sign of myelination. We need to repeat it to the children. We need to repeat it. After dropping the head, put them up. After the dropping head, put them up. Make them crawl. Make them sit. Make them stand. Likewise. This is simple technique for the myelination. Back to the child.
മലയാളത്തിലെ വെളിച്ചപ്പാട്, ഒട്ട് കേട്ട വെളിച്ചപ്പാട് വേർതിരിക്കാൻ പറ്റുമോ? ഒരു പറമ്പിൽ പച്ചത്തില്ല.
The same way, if we need to irritate one nerve positively, we need to irritate its agency outside. What are the agencies? If we are placing a nerve in our human body, if you are placing a nerve from the brain, there are millions of nerves are coming. Here, we cannot touch the nerve. We cannot touch the nerve. And what we will do, if you are placing a nerve like this, where it will end, you know, finally all nerves are ending into one muscle or one gland. One muscle or one gland. Otherwise, they will end into five sense organs. Five sense organs. Sense organs, what we know? Eyes, ear, nose, tongue, and skin. There are five sense organs, but one more is there. That is known as Narcissus. Medically, it is known as proprioception. 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 They are situated in the joints. How we are walking like this? By the help of this proprioception. If we have joint damage, we will have tendency to fall because our equilibrium will not disturb. Okay? Proprioception. There are six senses actually. And if we just stimulate these muscles or glands or these five sense organs, no doubt, even if you have to do it, if we stimulate these sense organs or if we stimulate the muscles or if we stimulate the glands, no doubt, the brain area cannot stay stagnant. This is the basic principle of new wiring. This is the basic principle of neuronal plasticity. This is the principle by which a hemiplegic patient, one side paralyzed patient, will later start to walk. Because all we know, once the neuron has dead, it is dead forever.
it will not regenerate, not like our other tissues. Other tissues are what is happening, you know, in other tissues, if we cut this, or if the tissues are getting injured or dying, there will be regeneration. Regeneration will be there. Brain will not regenerate. So what the damage has occurred, what patient has got paralyzed? One side has paralyzed after 1 or 3 months of physiotherapy or Ayurveda therapy. Physiotherapy, what they are doing? They are doing stimulation of muscles, glands, and the five sense organs. Later, what will happen? The adjacent neurons, the damaged neurons are here. Adjacent neuron will be activated by this physiotherapy, and after that, the patient will walk. Yeah. So this type of stimulation has to be given for making new good circuits. This is known as neuronal plasticity. Ayurkam. It is the functional division of our Ayurveda Pediatrics Department in our college, Ayurveda Center for Autism and Learning Disability Management. In Ayurkam Center, we have several techniques to stimulate these neurons, adjacent neurons, to make new neuronal circuit, to give good myelination, to give good circulation to the human brain. And those techniques I will introduce you one by one. They are grouped under these headings. One, Sukshma Vyayamas, subtle exercises, minute exercises. Clear? Number two, developmental Vyayamas, as I told you, patrolling and sitting stirrups, walking in one line, walking on one leg. The developmental place, there are different developmental, you know, not a lemon spoon rising. Tell us, I'm not going to do the spoon, cherry spoon, make you. അതിനുള്ളിൽ കൊള്ളാവുന്ന ഒരു ലെമൺ വയ്ക്കുന്നു അല്ലേ. ക്ലിയർ? വലിയ സ്പൂൺ ആണെന്നുണ്ടെങ്കിൽ ലെമൺ അതിനുള്ളിൽ നന്നായിട്ടിരിക്കും. ചെറിയ സ്പൂൺ വലിയ ലെമൺ ആണെങ്കിൽ ഇവിടെ കൂടുതൽ അഡ്ജസ്റ്റ് ചെയ്യണം. ആർക്ക്? ഹൂ ഈസ് ഗെറ്റിംഗ് ദിസ് ഇൻസൾട്ട്? ബ്രെയിൻ ഈസ് ഗെറ്റിംഗ്. വാട്ട് വി ആർ ഡൂയിങ്, യു ജസ്റ്റ് പുട്ട് എ സ്മോൾ സ്പൂൺ വിത്ത് എ സ്മോൾ വോളിയം സ്പേസ്, പുട്ട് എ ലാർജ് lemon upon it, so that he need to adjust it like this. Right? He will adjust it, and this cerebrum, periventricular region, amygdala nucleus, red nucleus, everything will be activated. I need to concentrate upon this one for a long time, and after that, I need to make it in a proper position so that it should not bend down. Right? This is very good exercise for children. Right? മ്യൂസിക്കൽ ചെയർ. മ്യൂസിക്കൽ ചെയറിന് വേണ്ട ഒരു കോൺസെൻട്രേഷൻ എന്തായിരിക്കും ആലോചിച്ച് നോക്കൂ. സോ ദ മ്യൂസിക്കൽ ചെയർ, ദിസ് ആർ ദ ഡെവലപ്മെന്റൽ പ്ലേസ് വാട്ട് വി ആർ ഡൂയിങ്. ദെൻ ആസനാസ്, ഡിഫറെന്റ് ആസനാസ്, മെനി ഓഫ് ദം യു ഹാവ് എക്സ്പീരിയൻസ് ഇൻ ദ മോർണിംഗ് സെഷൻ. സ്റ്റിൽ ഐ വിൽ ഷോ സം ആസനാസ് ദാറ്റ് ആർ ബെനിഫിഷ്യൽ ഫോർ ദീസ് പർപ്പസസ്. ബ്രീതിങ് എക്സസൈസസ്, സം ചാന്റിങ്. ചാന്റിങ് മീൻസ് യു നോ chanting mantras you might have heard, and chanting our religious rhymes, whether it may be any of the caste, religious rhymes, what is happening there? With a special concentration, we will be specially alert while in our pilgrim places or in religious places. We will be specially alert. Our five sense organs will be specially alert, and our adrenaline will be very active, adrenaline gland will be very active, and everything will be very active. In that time, we will chant something. Okay, then I will show you some other exercises. There are some tuition classes. Tuition classes are not appealing classes, to be frank with you, because we are not educational experts. We are not from this stream of higher and lower education department, that's why. But still, from medical point of view, we are putting some other things, like I will show. My date of birth is in 75. During our days, we first studied the letter R. Nowadays it is not like that. Nowadays in Malayalam,
Ra, Na, Ta, these are the letters.
Why?
You know, in 1 millimeter or 2 millimeter size of our toe-like poppy, our anterior poppy, in that we need to write this R. This R, like this, how many turns, how many curves,